Hi, welcome back to Web3 online YouTube channel. My name is Nikita. This channel is all about Rust programming language and Web3 technologies. I want to remind you that Ukrainians right now are still fighting for the freedom. I won't ask you to support, for any support. Thanks. So today we are going to talk about closures in Rust programming language, how we can declare them and how we can use them. So first I want to remind you that closures are pretty similar to regular function. We declare our closures almost the same way. At that 10 line we have declaration of add function, and at the 6th line we have declaration of our closures. We shouldn't specify parameter types, and also we shouldn't specify return type, because compiler is pretty smart to figure out it from context of our program. But in this case, when we didn't call our closures, compiler doesn't know what actually type are our parameters. But when we call these closures once, compiler will know it. So this how looks the evolution of declaration closures. We use this statement, pretty similar as in declaration of regular function. Also, we shouldn't use these kind of sharp brackets, because we have only one statement. We can store our closures to variables, and these variables contains pointer to some function that receive as parameter i32 and return i32 as type of value. This pretty hard declaration means that we declare closures which add these two values, and after this declaration we immediately call these closures and pass the value 1 and 2. Let's see how we can use our closures in more interesting way. So in this case we can pass function pointer to other function. So we declare function add, we declare other function that receive as parameter x i32 y i32 and parameter calc, like a function pointer with this type of parameters i32 and return value i32. So inside our function that receive other function we can call other function and pass any parameters. So we can pass parameter function pointer to this calc and print function. In this example we use already defined function add, and on the next line we declare other closures, other function, and pass this function as a parameter. Let's see how we can capture the local variable in our closures. So right now we don't see any exception. But if we try to use other local variable inside our closures, we will receive error. And why it happened? It's because our function calc and print receive as parameter calc function pointer. So we see this message: mismatched types expected function pointer fn i32 but found closures. So right now we really understand that closures and function pointer it's a little bit different things, and we can't pass closures as the regular function. And before to solve this issue, I want to show you how we can implement our closures, and it will be pretty similar how it really looks on the high level. So let's see that we declare structure, call it my closures. It contains field with i32. We declare trait my add with one function add, and we implement our trait for our structure. And in the body of our function, we see that we use the value that stored in structure. It looks pretty similar that we, for example, let z 10, we capture this z as a closure. So at the 9 line we create our closures and pass these closures to our function. Let's look a little bit deeper what's going on here. So as a result, as a type for calculator parameter, we declare that we want smart pointer box that contains inside any type that implement trait might add. So this is the trait that we declared before. And inside of our function, we call function add on our calculator. And the pretty similar that we pack our closures to smart pointer box and send them as a parameter to function. So maybe it looks a little bit like a magic that we can use our calculator like a simple object, but we have box, and this magic looks like that we are going to the reference, to the value of smart pointer, and call on this value function add. We shouldn't declare this statement because compiler is pretty smart to figure out that we are going to call function add on the value inside of the box. So now we saw and explore how we can implement our closures that capture the local variable. So let's back to the previous example, see what the issue was then. We see that we try to use z, but we got the error that our function won't receive function pointer, so it's literally print the so expected function pointer, but found closures. And it means that we should use for this purpose another trait, and this trait calls like fn. This trait help us store closures to variable of this type fn, and after this use it. So we create variable ff. It will be the type of smart pointer that contains any type that implement fn i32 as a parameter and return value i32. We declare our closures, and after that we pack this smart pointer to the box, and on the 11 line we can pass our closures as a parameter calc to our function calc and print. So again, if we use this kind of statement, let function pointer, so everything is good, so we can declare it. But if we won't pass our closures to other function as a parameter, we can't use function pointer, and we should wrap it as fn. So we just pass it to function pointer. That's all. Let's see that there exist other type of fn. It calls FnMut that help us to borrow mutable reference and change the value of variable inside the body. So there are two different way that we can declare. One way that we can declare mutable function, we use function pointer, so it's called function pointer that we store at calc variable, and we capture result to change it inside of our function pointer that we stored at our local variable. But if we want to pass this kind of logic, this kind of function to other function, we should wrap it as FnMut. So in this case we store closure in function mut variable before calling it. They're pretty interesting situation that if we try to print the new value of result variable, we will see an error that at this time result cannot borrow as immutable, because it still borrow as mutable. And why it's happened? It's happened because we still have mutable result inside the function, inside the closure that we declared before, and we should drop this variable, fn variable, to start use the result. Or we can do another way. We can declare that the scope of the life this variable will be live only inside these sharp brackets. So at this time we shouldn't use drop to release result that was captured at closures. There another case that we can use function pointer and trait FnOnce. In this case we declare some closures with keyword move, and it means that we capture s value inside our body, inside our body of closures. And another way we can do it, so we can use the same declaration of function pointer but wrap it to box and store the disclosures to FnOnce variable inside of smart pointer. Where we can use this strategic? We can use it in thread when we want to force our thread own the value. So in this case we declare our function pointer and we use this move keyword, and if we try to use s we'll got the error because value was moved in the thread. If we see at spawn method, it really use FnOnce trait, so it wrap our closures, it FnOnce trait and use it. So let's summarize that this everything that we talk in this video. So we discussed that there are two different types how we can create and use our closures. If we use FN, we store function pointer. If we use uppercase FN, we store our closures to variable of type FN. And there are three different type of trait for different purpose. FN just capture local variable but don't own it and don't mutate it. FnMut, it's captured the value of local variable and can mute it, mutate the value. And FnOnce, there are other trait that help us to move value to closure that we will declare. Thank you. Be sure that you push like and press subscribe. Have a nice day. Bye.